it's time for the freestyle skiing. Ladies aerials, final two, or it's being called here, the super final. And Weiss will go first from Germany. Lubov, Nikitina, Kristina Spiridonova really did jump well in the first final. The first jumper for Germany, Emma Weiss. A change in jump from the first final, where she went for a back full tuck. Now she's going for a back lay tuck. So not quite as difficult, so it has to be performed well. Emma Weiss gets us underway. And here, yep, a very happy landing. Won in the Europa Cup in Belarus earlier on this year, 11th in the World Championship, and she's backed it up with a strong finish here as well. Whether it's enough to qualify for a podium place, we will have to see. Weiss, who dropped her difficulty, going for quality. Remember, Alexandra Romanoshka, the world champion, goes third from last. There you have it, 63.96, Emma Weiss. Her work is done. Pressure time here in Krasnoyarsk. Shambota Alderbergenova goes for Kazakhstan. She's going big as well. Going as big as the other athletes at the top of the ranking so far. A back full, double full with a difficulty of 3.525. That's unbelievable, and it's landed as well. That's going to score nicely. First somersault with one twist, second somersault with two. Do we have an early contender? Emma Weiss, 63.96. Jambota Alderbergenova goes into goal position. 79.38. There's a score to beat. Jana Zsoldas from Kazakhstan, back lay tuck. Two somersaults, first one straight, second one in a tuck position. Sorry, back lay full, my mistake, back lay. There's a twist in the air as well. Landed, a degree of difficulty, 2.90. But where does that sit in comparison to Alderbergenova and Emma Weiss? High fives all round. There's your podium at the moment. But we still have three big, big players to come. One chance. Jana Zsoldas pushing for podiums here. 2.9 was a degree of difficulty. Goes into second, 68.38. Huge moments. Alexandra Romanoshka from Belarus, currently the in-form jumper in the world. World champion, currently in third place after the final, but that doesn't matter. Every jump based on its merit. Lay Fall Fall. Difficulty of 4.028. Three summies, and it's so, so high from the Belarusian. Lands it, stomps it. We might have a new leader. Smiles from the number one. Relief, maybe. The first summit. A straight layover. And then two somersaults, both with one twist. What will the judges think about that one? Surely. Incredible air. She began to practice freestyle at the age of six, taught by her mum. How proud must she be? We have a new leader by over 20 points as well. Two left. This is incredible scenes, and the pressure is really on Christina. Spreed on over here. The back double, full, full. Two summits. First one with two twists. Second somersault with one.
Double.
3.525 is the difficulty here. Not as high as Romanovska. In she goes, Spiridonova. She needs a good landing here. Oh, and she goes over the front. Russia, as they did in the men's. A crash landing in the women's. Devastation you have to feel for Christina Spiridonova. You really do. Second in the World Cup in Deer Valley in 2018, 11th in the Olympic Games, and under big, big pressure, you have to make your landings count. Started at 11. Who as a child dreamed of being an astronaut. Almost the next best thing. But where will she be on the leaderboard? Precious moments. Spiridonova, fifth place, no podium for the Russian. And you have to feel for it. So already, Romanovska is sitting in goal position again. Alda Berganova in second. Lubov Nikitina, pressure is on the Russian with a back double full fall. Two summies, two twists, one twist on the second summy, stomped. The Russian crowd love it. The degree of difficulty, 3.525. But where does that sit against the jump of Alexandra Romanovska from Belarus? We're about to find out. She could not have done any more. The only question is against the degree of difficulty. The Belarusian Romanovska really went for it. She really did. Precious moments. Also looking closely will be Zhambota Alda Berganova, who currently sits in silver. Ayana Zoldas from Kazakhstan is a Kazakhstan 2-3, silver, bronze. But will Russia take gold, silver, bronze? Will it be enough? She has to be somewhere near it. Lubov Nikitina takes silver. Amanovska from Belarus. Hugs all round as the Belarusian takes another win. The result, after winning the World Championships last month, Alexandra Romanovska takes the gold again. Russia takes silver. Lubov Nikitina at the last hurdle. And it's a great result for the high-flying athlete from Kazakhstan, Zhambota Alderbergenova, takes the bronze with a jump of 79.38. So it's time for the men. Could it be as breathtaking as the women's final? Maxim Burov, who was flying in the first final, goes last as it's in reverse order. First up, Ilda Badrutdinov from Kazakhstan, going with the back full double full. Degree of difficulty of 3.525 to get us underway. Tension is building. Oh, and it's a crash landing. Devastation. You get one chance in this competition to land a run. The local fans will be slightly happier with that, but it's just disappointing for Kazakhstan. He's performed so well. Badrutdinov. Almost the same trick and jump as the first. Back double full full. Just changed the rotations of the jumps, going back full double full this time. Where will that sit? You can see the disappointment in the face and the body language of Ilda Badrutdinov. 50.76. Probably won't be challenging for the podium. Big moments. Vyacheslav Samadsel from Belarus, just 18, going for the back full double full. Again, just a change of the jump from the previous final. This one has a difficulty of 3.525. Big moments for Belarus. Lands it under pressure. Krasnoyarsk, we have a lander in the men's final. Great jump. Some big, big jumpers to come, though. Second in the Europa Cup, 12th in the Junior Championships in 2016. Done very well here. Patience. Samadsel. Waiting. Should go to the top of the leaderboard, and does. First place, 86.01. But there are some big, big jumpers, as mentioned previously, coming up. And here's one. Li Xiongling won this competition in Kazakhstan 2 years ago. Can he replicate the same form? Here's his chance. Back double, full, full. Landed. There's a statement of intent. That might just put the pressure on the rest of the field. He knows he can do it on this stage, at this moment, and crushes it. First somersault, two twists. One twist. On the second, Sami. Massive, absolutely massive.
ты знаешь, там прорыв.
And look how much it means to everyone around him. Deep breaths for Li Shongling from China. 14th in Lake Placid in January. That result in Kazakhstan, the Universiad, 2 years ago was his biggest. Now he's at the top again. 87.77, just in front of Simzatzau. Russia, Ruslan Kadmanov, has already won in Moscow this year in the Europa Cup. Big moments though. Clutch performance needed. Kadmanov going for the back full, double full. Two summies, three rotation, lands it. Siberia are on their feet again. And when the pressure is on, Kadmanov just delivers. Two somersaults, one twist followed by two. Li Shongling is at the top of the leaderboard. Vyacheslav Smadzal from Belarus in second. Ildar Badrutdinov in third. One jump for a medal. The judges need to let us know what's going on. 87.77, second place. Joint first even. Both athletes on 87.77. Incredible scenes as we have a tight lead.
Okay.
Gao Siming from China goes. Big moments, pressure, third in this competition. 2 years ago, what's he got? He's gone huge. And it's a massive crash. The back, full, 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 three rotations with three twists. Didn't pay off. It's the most difficult jump we've seen in this final so far. To no avail. Yard sailing. Gao Siming went for broke, and you have to really respect that, though. So a tied score in firstly, Shongling, Ruslan Kadmanov. They won't be troubled, though, by Gao Siming. .42, it's good, it's fourth place due to the degree of difficulty. One man left to go from Russia. The back double, full, full, full. It's massive. It's three somersaults. The first one has two twists. The second one has one. The third also has one. The world champion from Deer Valley has to make this one count. Also a winner on the World Cup. Can he? Yes, he can. It's a massive jump. On the big stage, on the big occasion. Maxim Burov, composed, incredible. Potentially the gold medalist. Edge of your seat stuff from the aerials. Итак,
Руслан Гатманов, Россия, Ли Цунли, Китай лидирует, и посмотрим, что же выставит.
Intense, but the height of the jump. Буров. Three somersaults. The first one. Two twists. The second two with one twist. It's the toughest jump we've seen in this final. 4.525. Can he? Is the question. It's with the judges. He's throwing everything at him. He's left everything out there, Maxim Buров. But is he the gold medalist here from Krasnoyarsk? You would think so, but it's down to the judges. 87.77 are the scores to be. He's absolutely crushed it. By a mile, Maxim Buroff, 119.91. Unstoppable. What an evening. Maxim Buroff stomps it out of the park, 119.91. Li Xiongling, another medal in this competition. After taking bronze last time, takes a silver this time, and Kamenov from Russia takes third. Good performance from Kamenov as well. The flower ceremony for the aerials is underway, the 29th Winter Universiad in Krasnoyarsk, the heart of Siberia. A win in the World Championships, a win in the World Cup in Moscow 2 weeks ago. It's now the gold medalist from the freestyle skiing at Krasnoyarsk 2019. There are our medalists, and they will be celebrating, we are sure, for a long, long time. The men's aerials. Victory ceremony from Krasnoyarsk. Maxim Buroff takes the gold. Li Xiongling, silver. Ruslan Kamenov with the bronze. Russia 1-3, China 2. We're going to leave you with some pictures and some highlights, and we'll see you again tomorrow.